the show, we are giving you the big takeaways from what has been one of the most interesting elections in our times. But before that, let's... My team is telling me no headlines. Let's quickly give our viewers the big takeaways. So that's what we'll do. We'll defer to the wisdom of the newsroom. Ladies and gentlemen, in the last 10 hours, we have seen historic victories and humbling lessons. I want to take 2 minutes of your time to take a look at what 2024 means for the big guns. Let's start with Prime Minister Modi. Has there been a dent to brand Modi? Yes, there has been a dent to brand Modi. The BJP on its own, well, it's still the single largest party, but it's still not managed the numbers it requires to form the government on its own. 272 on its own, it's still not managed. The Modi ki guarantee has failed to take the BJP home. Is this a credibility crisis? Very importantly, the margin of his victory in Banaras has actually dropped by 60%. If you remember, in 2019, it was somewhere around 4 lakh. This time, the victory margin has dropped to 1.5 lakh. Very good, but a drop of 60%. What about Rahul Gandhi? We just saw him a few minutes ago. Well, he's managed to retain his family bastion, Raebareli, with a thumping victory. Actually, he's bettered his mother's record from last time. 10% better. The victory margin is about 4 lakh votes. He's proving, and what essentially the results are showing is that there has been resonance of the Congress key guarantees, especially the 30 lakh rupee jobs. I'll speak to my guests about that if that was the only thing. But the Congress key guarantees, it seems people were willing to believe it on the ground. He has led the Congress to its best tally in Uttar Pradesh to 2009. The Congress party, I think, is nearly... The Congress party in Uttar Pradesh is getting about 7 seats. If you remember, in 2019, Raebareli was the only seat that the Congress party had won. This time, the leads are in 7 seats, including, ladies and gentlemen, Amethi, which Kishori Lal Sharma of the Congress party has won. Smriti Irani has lost the seat of Amethi to a virtual unknown. He's very well known in Amethi, but not outside Amethi. Has Rahul Gandhi buried the ghost of 2014 and 2019 with 2024 and the results that we are seeing across India? Perhaps yes, but it can be a subject of debate. Speaking of Smriti Irani, the lady on your screens, it's a humbling defeat for Smriti Irani. She has lost to a Gandhi family aide. He's someone, Kishori Lal Sharma, for anyone who knows him or has been to Amethi, has covered Amethi, will tell you that he's been a family loyalist for the longest time. When his name was suddenly announced to fight the Amethi elections, he said, "Arre, mujhe bhi nahi pata, ye kya ho gaya? No one asked me." Smriti Irani essentially has now gone from being the giant killer to the fallen giant. That is as far as Smriti Irani is concerned. Let's shift our focus from Uttar Pradesh to the second most electorally significant state in our country, that is Maharashtra, has 48 seats. Uddhav Thackeray, the big gainer here. He has successfully claimed the Shiv Sena and the Balasaheb legacy. That is very clear. He's got the backing of the Marathi Manus. I think that is something that the elections are making very clear. Has this set the tone for the big MVA victory in the assembly elections? Remember, Maharashtra goes to the polls this year itself, so does Haryana. We'll just have to wait and watch. Staying with Maharashtra, Sharad Pawar. He's cut nephew Ajit Pawar to size. He showcased his hold over Maratha politics once again. Most importantly, Supriya Sule, his daughter, has defeated Ajit Pawar's wife Sunetra and won the family bastion of Baramati in style. So essentially, to cut a long story short, in Maharashtra, the people of Maharashtra, forget what the courts have said, the people of Maharashtra have decided who the real Shiv Sena is and who the real NCP is, irrespective of who has the symbol. Mamata Banerjee, ladies and gentlemen, you've just heard her. What was the big prediction? The big prediction was that the BJP is going to do extremely well in West Bengal, get more seats than the TMC, sweep it in one sense. That has not happened. Mamata Banerjee has retained her citadel with big wins. She has brushed aside the BJP's challenge. She has proven detractors wrong over Sandesh Khali, very importantly. So that's the West Bengal story. The BJP was hoping to make stunning inroads here. They'd done very well last time, remember, winning 18 seats. The predictions were for them to go up to 22. That hasn't happened. Chandrababu Naidu. He stormed back to power in style. He swept aside Jagan Mohan Reddy's Vice RCP. He's emerged as a kingmaker in the Lok Sabha as well. Essentially, he's the next chief minister of Andhra Pradesh, and he's in a position to decide who rules in Delhi. At the moment, he has an alliance firmly in place with the NDA. Akhilesh Yadav, gentlemen, क्या हो रहा है भाई? There's some big breaking news coming in. We were just speaking about Chandrababu Naidu, and it seems there's a suspense over Mr. Naidu's alliance pick. As I said, this is interesting. This is what Indian politics and elections are about. Sure. Mr. Chandrababu Naidu has called off the press conference he was supposed to do. Okay. Now his team is saying he will not be able to speak to the media. ये तो बड़ी अजब और गजब बात है, because he has won the
landslide victory.
Landslide victory.
Yeah, yeah. He don't speak on.
Won the state.
He doesn't need the BJP.
He's won the state, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen. And he's won the Lok Sabha elections in his state as well. So chief minister हैं, kingmaker भी हैं, but गला खराब हो गया suddenly, Tehsin.
So गला खराब हो गया और the way things are going to be. So let's get everything right.
No, I want you on this first. This is extremely interesting.
I'm coming on this. I'm exactly coming on this. This is a prelude to what's going to happen. And therefore, I'm just putting the scenario out. Number one, the president of India, she is duty bound to call NDA and the BJP. She's duty bound. It's the single largest pre-party, pre-poll alliance. It's the single largest political party. She can't call anyone else. Unless the pre-poll, single largest pre-poll alliance, NDA, cannot form the government. So once Prime Minister Modi is Prime Minister and she has 15 days to prove a majority, he's going to do his thing. But what is interesting with BJP not touching 272 is, you're not seeing the same Prime Minister Modi now. The same Prime Minister Modi, you can come on air and say, in 4 hours, main notbandi kar raha, in 4 hours, I'm putting a lockdown. That won't happen. Now, I have another theory out here. With what Chandrababu Naidu ji just did, or before that, what Nitish ji tweeted, and I don't know if you saw the tweet of Nitish ji, Nyay aur Vikas jeete hai. You have to understand what Nitish ji tweeted.
Nyay aur Vikas
ke saath. So good. What's happened is, you now know that the trajectory is going to be that the BJP or Prime Minister Modi will not be able to take all decisions so much as he does. Will Prime Minister Modi now, he also has a card to play, play the Rajiv Gandhi ji card, where Rajiv Gandhi, despite being the single largest party, said, listen, I will sit in opposition, aap banao. This is interesting. This is not over till it's over.
It's not over till the fat lady sings, as they say. This is not over till it's over. Yeah. Tomorrow is going to be very interesting. If today has been interesting, tomorrow is going to be a thriller by the looks of it.
And I can promise you, all flights to Delhi are running full.
Acha.
And all the private chartered flights are booked out.
Too much money politicians have. Money has been spent in this election. Anyhow, Tehsin, I believe you have to be on another channel. So,
do I?
Yeah, I think so. So, no. anyhow, stay if you can. Karan Verma, would you want to hazard a guess as to what exactly is happening?
You know, we can have fun while it lasts, but I think in the end, they are all going to gravitate towards the NDA. Yes, it has given them immense bargaining power now. Mr. Nitish Kumar, jise kehte hai na, sari ungliyan ghee ke andar hai. So Mr. Nitish Kumar and Mr. Chandrababu Naidu, right now, kuch punya kiye honge unhone, that they are in this unique position where barely having a few seats makes them kingmakers.
Karan, Nitish Kumar for Deputy Prime Minister?
That's what I said, and suddenly NDA alliance started floating it.
Nitish
Kumar for Deputy Prime
all
Minister.
All this right now is, as they say, newsroom ki gapshap.
Correct.
And all source-based, and no one knows what this source
what
is.
What do you think Mr. Nitish Kumar is aiming at?
What do you think Mr. Nitish Kumar is aiming at right now?
We all know Mr. Nitish Kumar. Do we know Mr. Nitish Kumar? Can anyone dare to know?
Nitish Kumar. What does the tweet, Nyay aur Vikas Saath Saath? What does that tweet
What I'm hearing now, when you're talking about gapshap, I can tell you what I'm hearing right now from some good sources. Nitish Kumar is not entertaining any phone call, anything from the BJP side right now. Now, is he trying to act pricey? Is he trying to, you know, bargain? I don't know what he's trying to do. He's a master negotiator. Let's admit that. Somebody who has been able to form multiple governments within three, four months. You've got to give it to the man.
Can I just come in here and I just want to see our other guests on the show as well. I know in politics, it's Sam Dam Dan Bhed. I understand that. But Mr. Nitish Kumar has a bit of a reputation, and you'll agree with that. Would the India Alliance want to go with someone who lacks credibility? I mean, the election has been fought It's been a they've led a decent campaign. They've batted for decency, doing the right thing, etc., etc. Now you go with someone who's called Paltu-Ram.
But the BJP is also doing it with Paltu-Ram. But look,
BJP ka to pehle se alliance hai na unke saath. That's a different thing.
Alliance tod ka alliance ko uske pehle wo alliance uske pehle. We can't. But look, I'll tell you what.
Inception.
If you were to ask me what the India Alliance should do, they should gracefully sit in opposition. This is the moment for Rahul Gandhi. Today is his day, right? He should now become leader of opposition. He should take up that responsibility with articulation, with good command over both English and Hindi. He should raise issues of the nation and thereby hold the Prime Minister and the government to accountability, something that Lok Sabha has not seen for a long time because of the tyranny of the numbers. You now, with the 230-odd, have the numbers to hold Lok Sabha accountable. The Speaker will have to give you more time. They cannot move the camera away when Rahul Gandhi will speak or Akhilesh Yadav ji will speak. UCC is out, one nation. And I tell you what, I see, and Karan, you help me out here, I see some very positive thing here. With the BJP actually winning Odisha, doing well in Andhra or the way it's done, it does set the tone for BJP to being slightly more diverse. Imagine the Prime Minister is fighting the election on mutton and machi. Ab wo mudde hi nahi hoge na
anymore.
I just want to before I go to Uttar Pradesh, where the second big story is developing, the one big story that is developing is Chandrababu Naidu. Scheduled press conference. He is the king of Andhra, the kingmaker of Delhi. Scheduled press conference, suddenly he has cancelled. He says he doesn't want to speak today. Rahul Gandhi has asked a question on whether he is going to join hands, whether he's going to offer a handshake to Chandrababu Naidu and to Nitish Kumar. He's saying, bhai, we respect our allies. Kal baat karenge is bare mein. Jairam Ramesh before that has already tweeted that if we come to power, Andhra Pradesh gets special status. So all this is going in one direction, ladies and gentlemen. So that is where the story is now developing. Clyde Crasto, you are part of the India Alliance. Is it your sense that the India Alliance could make up its mind not to sit in the opposition and give government formation a real shot?
Well, Shreya, I just heard you saying it ain't over till the fat lady sings, or it ain't over till the last ball is bowled. All I can say is, since we're talking about movies and stuff, there's a movie called Creed, and Sylvester Stallone says, one step, one punch, one round at a time. But wait, that's what's going to happen now. We'll wait and watch. And BJP has been given a nice punch by the people of India. So we'll wait and watch.
True. But the mandate, look, by the end of the day, the mandate is with the NDA. Let us not forget that. They have 293 seats. 272 is the halfway mark. They are down 57. The India bloc has done extremely well, but they don't have the mandate to rule. The mandate to rule given by this country is to the NDA. A diminished mandate, yes, but that is how things stand. We'll see how things play out. I'm just going to slip into a very quick break on the show. Up next, I want to look closely at the state of Uttar Pradesh. What a surprise this has thrown us. That's up next. Do stay with us.
Co-presented by Amazing Spaces ke liye Green Lime Laminates. Kuch mera, kuch tumhara. Co-presented by New Seltos with Kia Connect. Tech is now badass. Co-powered by UPES, University of Tomorrow.
Seeing the field from every angle. The safest fielder never lets anything miss his eye. Navigates his way under the ball without any stress. The legendary player, champion of champions. The feature-loaded Nexon, India's number one SUV for 3 years in a row. Price starts at 7.99 lakhs.
Thank you, Janta. आपने हमारी पार्टी बना दी, अब पार्टी कर लो।
Subscribe for just rupee one. Download the app now.
औलाद साम बनके चिंगारियों में पलके मैं बनाऊंगा। उम्मीदों के पंख कंधों पे लगा के मैं बनाऊंगा। बनाऊंगा मैं तो।
Skills, steel और दिल से बन रहा है भारत। AMNS India, smarter steels, brighter futures.
Ladies and gentlemen, the big story is also coming from Uttar Pradesh today. The BJP definitely not Uttam in Uttar Pradesh. The Samajwadi Party cycle is cruising its way to the top. As we speak, I am looking at the numbers that are coming to me from the Election Commission. That's all I'm going by. These are leads, and I mean now it's more than 6:30. So these leads are solidifying. The Samajwadi Party, ladies and gentlemen, is leading in 37 seats, which is four more than the BJP. The BJP right now is leading in 33 seats. Who would have imagined this? Did no one see this coming? By the looks of it, no one did. The Indian National Congress, last time, 2019, it was at one. The only seat that the Congress party won was the seat of Rai Bareli. The Indian National Congress now leading in six seats. The RLD, which is a partner of the BJP, formerly partner in the India bloc, is doing well as well. Two. Point is, now if there is an effort being made to wean away allies of the NDA, of the BJP, to the India bloc, will the RLD be approached as well? We'll see, but it's a stellar resurgence of UP ke do ladke, Rahul Gandhi and Akhilesh Yadav. They were called Shehzadas by the Prime Minister. They have given a body blow to the Bharatiya Janata Party. The performance in the key Hindi heartland has left the BJP red-faced across all 80 seats. Remember, they had 62. The BJP had 62 in 2019. The estimate of the exit polls was that the BJP individually on its own will probably manage to get a little more seats, say three or four more seats. But privately, in Lucknow, the talk was that we will go down a bit, say to about 60, we'll lose a couple of seats, but not more than that. The Samajwadi Party has emerged as the principal opponent of the BJP in UP. Again, just reading the numbers that we are seeing on, that I am seeing on the Election Commission website, 80 seats overall in the state of Uttar Pradesh. The Samajwadi Party leading in 37, the BJP leading in 33, the Indian National Congress in 6, and the RLD is leading in 2. So that's the story as it stands right now. And since we are speaking of Uttar Pradesh, ladies and gentlemen, also an interesting tidbit, Ayodhya, Faizabad constituency, right, Ayodhya, right. That has been won by the Samajwadi Party, exactly. Not the BJP. Can I just quickly then go to my guest this evening? Namaskar, you're back, Mr. Silas. Thank yes. you very much. Khush to aaj bahut honge aap.
Yes, yes, bilkul bahut khush hai aur Uttar Pradesh ki janta ka बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद भी करते हैं जिस तरह से उन्होंने इंडिया अलायंस और समाजवादी पार्टी द वे दे हैव सपोर्टेड अस इज रियली फिनोमिनल एंड वी कुड सी इट दिस कमिंग इफ आई टेल यू टेक्निकली व्हाट हैपेंड इन 2022 वी वर जस्ट 3.5 to 4% लेस देन द
भारतीय जनता पार्टी आप लोगों की
ना ना मैं 22 के चुनाव की बात कर रहा हूं
अच्छा मैं 2019 की बात कर रही हूं
हां मैं 22 की बात कर रहा हूं जो विधानसभा का चुनाव हुआ था इफ यू सी द लार्जर पिक्चर वी वर जस्ट 3,25,000 वोट लेस देन द भारतीय जनता पार्टी Though the Bharatiya Janata Party formed the government in 2022, but we fell short by 3,25,000 votes in entire UP. And we knew if we work hard, this was very evident, it had to come because the people of Uttar Pradesh trust in the Samajwadi Party and it's shown. Because the Bharatiya Janata Party and the media also, when we started debating, they were just giving us two seats. Hmm. And one they were giving to the Congress and one seat to the Samajwadi Party, that too of Mainpuri. According to the media, everyone was losing in Uttar Pradesh except the Bharatiya Janata Party. So now the mandate that has come is really phenomenal and I congratulate everyone in the, who has worked hard in the Samajwadi Party.
I'll get to the exit poll in just a bit, because there are big question marks on the exit polls that came out day before yesterday. Big, big question marks actually now. But Ruhi Tiwari, you have traveled in Uttar Pradesh, Karan. I know you want to come in. Matthew Antony, good evening. Thank you very much. I see you as well on the screens. Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay, thank you very much for being with us. You know, we'll just come to you in just in a bit. But Ruhi Tiwari, you're someone who traveled in Uttar Pradesh, and we were talking about this earlier as well. It seems everyone missed what was happening in Uttar Pradesh. Everyone, almost everyone missed it.
Absolutely. Absolutely, absolutely. And there is, I mean, I have no qualms in admitting that I was on the ground in Uttar Pradesh and I missed it. You know, you can call it a huge sort of wave, in a sense, for the Samajwadi Party to go back, to go up from 5 seats to 30 plus seats and to reduce BJP to a lesser number. It is it would require that sort of a wave to bring the BJP down. So it's really quite inexplicable what happened. The candidate selection perhaps was a huge sort of victory for the Samajwadi Party. It managed to do it very well. The alliance, as I mentioned earlier on the show in the morning, the vote transfer between the Samajwadi Party and Congress finally happened. It's something that they were struggling with in, for instance, the 2017 assembly elections. That seems to have finally happened, and that seems, so they've probably cracked that code, having gone through it earlier. So maybe a lot of things have come together for the Samajwadi Party. But just one small thing, Shreya, before you move on, is, the Congress, it's done very well as compared to its last tally. I mean, it was obviously, it had gone down to its all-time low in 2014, so it could only go up from there. But the question the Congress needs to ask itself is whether it can be in a position by 2029 to become a party that can get 200-plus seats and become the fulcrum of a proper coalition government, instead of just staying at this 100 figure. And for that, it needs a state like Uttar Pradesh, which sends 80 MPs minus allies. It needs to be able to rebuild itself in big states like Uttar Pradesh, in states like Maharashtra, minus allies, to be able to become a party that can get 200 plus seats. So that's something the Congress will have to think about going forward in terms of its strategy.
But what we are seeing, and I'm going to get Matthew Antony in here, but what we are seeing is the resurgence of the Congress party. If you look at the data that the Election Commission is putting out to us, the Congress right now is leading in some 94 seats, which means, and it was 52 last time, which means it's nearly doubled its tally. Matthew Antony, well done. But my question to you is again this. Is this a mandate for you to govern, or is this a mandate for you, according to you, to sit in the opposition?
Shreya, thanks for taking me in.
We've been waiting for 10.
Yeah, can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead. Good evening.
Okay, good evening. So I've been waiting for some time.
Yeah, I can. Good evening. Go ahead. Love and
care. We've been doing for the last 10 years. And it's paying off. And one thing which I should do is that we should congratulate our leader Rahul Gandhi for traveling crisscross this country with the Bharat Jodo Yatra, which is created the foundation for his victory, and also the Mallikarjun Kharge's leadership and the whole Congress party's leadership to stitch the India Alliance together. We did a lot of sacrifice to put the alliance together. We partnered with a lot of parties who inflicted damages on the previous elections, but we stood for a national cause, and it has paid the results, and it has paid back, and we have performed well. Now, looking into the mandate, Modi's guarantees has completely failed. Look at the result in the
some network issue, I believe.
The moment he said Modi ki guarantee failed, the frame froze.
Are you digital India to frame nahi ho, fail nahi ho
raha. Frame froze ho gaya because it was so incorrect ki freeze kar gaya wahi pe.
Okay. Karan, would you want to come in on the question of Uttar Pradesh?
Yeah, please. I want to explain this. Yeah.
Because here's the point. Mm-hmm. I come from Uttar Pradesh and you come from Uttar Pradesh as well.
Mr.
Silas is from Uttar Pradesh. So all three of us here in the studio are from Uttar Pradesh. The fact is, if you went to Lucknow, If you went to Banaras,
right,
you'd be told that there has been delivery. There has been delivery, not just as far as the ration is concerned. There's delivery, not just as far as the Ram Mandir is concerned, but the roads have become much better. Bijli nahi jaati hai, pani aata hai. There has been delivery. And most importantly, for Uttar Pradesh and Yogi Adityanath, the one big tick mark he always got, 10 out of 10 in one subject that he got, was law and order. Anyone you speak to in Lucknow say, Samajwadi Party is gundas. But that's the perception, right? But Yogi Adityanath, they call him Bulldozer Baba, aake inhone law and order theek kar diya hai. If there were so many pluses,
right?
As far as the BJP is concerned in Uttar Pradesh, hua kya? Now, I'll tell you the conspiracy theory I've heard today. That the RSS has worked against the BJP in Uttar Pradesh. This is a conspiracy theory. Of course, these are things that will circulate. But anyhow, what's your analysis?
So, you know, just 30 seconds on what all has been delivered in UP. UP has leapfrogged from the 7th largest economy of the country to the 3rd. 3 crore tap water connections, 3.5 crore toilets given, ration given. Law and order has improved, giant strides in law and order. And still, today, we see this kind of a mandate. So what does this tell you? In 2017, Akhilesh was decimated. He ran on his record, jo kaha kiya, and he was decimated in 2017. 19, they lost. 2022, they lost. They lost by 7%. He can pick up the cherry pick the number of votes, but there was a 7% sizable vote share difference. What happened this time? It's the fact that there was local anti-incumbency against the candidates and the candidate selection was poor. The cadres didn't support the candidate that was chosen. They didn't work as hard as they had to, perhaps. It is in no way a referendum on the Prime Minister.
When you lose, you say candidates ki ganti hai. When you win, you say the mandate is for Modi ji.
Abhi bhi the highest vote share in UP is of BJP. SP plus Congress ka vote share bhi BJP se kam hai. If you check, 43.5% hai BJP ka. So it's not that BJP has capitulated. They are still holding on to their vote share of 44%. It's just that because of poor candidate selection, the cadres at the ground, they got disgruntled, which is a tactical mistake. Let's own it. BJP has made this blunder. But in no way can you say that governance hasn't happened, as you rightly said, in UP. And in no way is this a referendum on the Prime Minister or Yogi Adityanath. And I'm telling you, they will course correct in due time. So yes, today is a day for our great friend Vivek ji to celebrate. But this celebration won't last long because BJP is going to course correct in due time.
अच्छा चलो आई थिंक यस क्लाइड हाय गो अहेड प्लीज
हाय नो श्रेया आई जस्ट वांट टू यू नो रिपीट व्हाट आई सेड अर्लियर प्रोबब्ली ऑन योर चैनल बट विद सम अदर एंकर द पॉइंट हियर इज एवरीवेयर यू वेंट अक्रॉस द कंट्री एंड आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट से आई ट्रैवल्ड महाराष्ट्र ड्यूरिंग द इलेक्शन एंड इन मुंबई देयर वर ह्यूज कटआउट्स ऑफ मोदी जी द कैंडिडेट्स देमसेल्व्स वर टोल्ड दैट यू नीड टू आस्क वोट्स इन द नेम ऑफ मोदी जी People were going around saying that, please vote for Modi ji. Nobody knew who the candidate was. So today, if the mandate of the Bharatiya Janata Party has come down, then the mandate is against Narendra Modi ji. I mean, if you're asking for votes in the name of Modi ji, and you're not getting the amount of votes or amount of seats that you are asking for, then I think the people of India has rejected the leadership of Narendra Modi ji. So the fact is, I mean,
Karan, please
you
remember
that you will cross
the number of seats for the BJP
has
half
400
in the state.
Yeah.
From 62 to 33.
So what has happened is, Shriya, this 400 par, apki bar 400
exactly.
par, this has backfired.
No, so that's what I'm trying to say. The mandate
people
is against
Modi ji.
I'll let Matthew Antony come in.
Sure.
But you know, maybe there are people who have voted against the Prime Minister as well. Why would you say that this is not
people,
this is not a mandate against the Prime Minister?
He's hugely you know, there popular is a, there and is, he's delivered also.
No, he's popular, all
he
right.
He has delivered as a factual statement.
I will give you that. I'll give you that. He's popular. And I will also give you that right now the BJP is the single largest party. But there is an undecided voter. That floating voter who has not decided, who's not ideologically committed, who has not decided, main kiske liye vote karunga.
That voter perhaps didn't like the local candidate.
No, that voter perhaps didn't like Mutton, Mujra,
picked up in the entire campaign,
Mangal
and
Sutra,
generalized it.
Muslim, Bhens.
And tap water you miss, what toilets you miss, ration you miss. This is convenient. Shreya, this is really convenient.
Shreya.
One statement out of the entire
campaign. Aapki bhi to convenient hai. Where you are saying that MP, there was disgruntlement against the local MPs.
To
ye bhi to baat galat hai na.
Abhi tak Sapa kyun nahi
jeet rahi? Actually, nothing makes sense in this election.
It makes sense. Sapa, why was Sapa losing till now? Aap batao mujhe. मुझे. Oh, suddenly they started with
Matthew Antony wants to come in and then Mr. Silas. हाँ. अच्छा डिंपल यादव बोल रही हैं. Let's quickly listen into her. The Samajwadi Party's day, so let's listen into her.
Samajwadi विचारधारा का जो समर्थन किया है और जिस तरह का साथ और आशीर्वाद दिया, तो सबसे पहले तो मैं उनको दिल से धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगी. इसी के साथ समाजवादी पार्टी की प्राथमिकता रहेगी कि मैनपुरी का विकास आगे कैसे बढ़े.
इंडिया गठबंधन ने बड़ा अच्छा प्रदर्शन किया है, अप्रत्याशित परिणाम आए हैं, कैसे देख रही हैं आप, क्या कहना चाहती हैं?
मैं समझती हूँ उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता ने भारतीय जनता पार्टी को एक सबक सिखाने का काम किया है, उनका अहंकार उनकी तृष्णा को तोड़ने का काम किया है कहीं ना कहीं. और जिस तरह सभी समाज और सभी वर्ग के लोग एक साथ आए और जिस तरह समर्थन दिया, क्योंकि सभी लोग त्रस्त हैं और जो मौजूदा सरकार थी वो ये मानने को तैयार नहीं थी कि जनता परेशान है, कि युवा परेशान है, कि हमारी माताएं बहनें परेशान है, कि किसान परेशान है, कि मजदूर बुनकर सभी लोग परेशान है, और कहीं ना कहीं ये लोगों की जीत है.
लगातार ये देखा जा रहा है कि इंडिया गठबंधन अब अपने प्रधानमंत्री
चुनाव करने वाला है.
समाजवादी पार्टी.
ओके, दैट्स अ टफ क्वेश्चन टू आंसर. That's a tough question to answer. So wisely, Dimple Yadav has decided. Chalo, wo jo soundbite dena hai, de diya. She was of course fighting on a Samajwadi Party ticket from Venpuri, which is her father-in-law's seat, and she has won that. But come in, Vivek. You were responding to what was being said here.
You were talking about the popularity of the honorable Prime Minister. So if you see what happened in Varanasi, the Prime Minister managed to win that seat by a margin of 1,52,000 votes. Only. Last time he won the Varanasi seat by 4,86,000 votes. So you can see the popularity of Prime Minister in his Lok Sabha in Varanasi has come down very, very low. Secondly, Honorable Dimple Ji was right here. She has won the margin of Dimple Yadav Ji was more than the Prime Minister himself. If you see Rai Bareilly, Rahul Gandhi is winning by 4 lakh votes. So these are the margin that we are getting. Okay. And if you see, see Varanasi and see Purvanchal. On the top is Gorakhpur, and on the south, if you see Purvanchal, is Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji as of now. What happened to all the adjoining seats? They've lost and they've crashed. Why? Because the people of Uttar Pradesh don't trust either on Chief Minister Yogi or Prime Minister Modi.
I don't think that's what they lost badly.
It's not that you have won by 10,000, 12,000. We are winning by lakhs of vote. So what does it show?
I agree. But that's because of the local candidate. You can't say that Yogi Adityanath is not popular. Can you say Yogi Adityanath is not popular? Please
say that.
He's very popular. So is the Prime Minister. They're perhaps two of the most popular leaders we have in the country.
Why only 1,52,000 votes in Varanasi? Why only 1,52,000 votes in Varanasi?
I think complacency. That is where complacency. Everybody took it for granted that the Prime Minister is winning anyway. And that's where the
That is why they didn't vote for him. Come on.
No, he did win by 1,50,000. Yes. He's won. I don't know what the margin
Prime
is, but he's won it comfortably.
By 152. Achha, is a loss to the Prime Minister.
So one question, Vivek ji, what has Akhilesh done in the last 1 year or 2 years that suddenly he's catapulted to these heights? He didn't catapult to these heights.
Clearly something right.
Something wrong has been done by the BJP local candidate.
Are.
It is this disappointment which is showing
us.
I am blaming the local candidate. When you fought this election in the name of Prime Minister Modi, Karan, come on.
Mujhe batao na, main aapse ek logical question poochunga. अरे मैं आपकी बात मान रहा हूँ सर, आप जीत गए, बहुत अच्छी बात है. आप मुझे बताओ एकदम से क्या हुआ that people started voting for Akhilesh Yadav?
Because the people of UP started distrusting the Prime Minister.
Not the Prime Minister, the local candidate. If they had distrusted the Prime Minister, then
eventually they had to vote for the Prime Minister.
Matthew Antony, you are raising your hand. Go ahead. I mean, go ahead. You're smiling, you're laughing, and you're also raising your hand. Go ahead, please.
Let us accept the defeat of Modi because it was on Modi's guarantee they have fought the election. And they have lost the majority as a single party. So that is very clear.
They haven't lost.
Let us give the credit. Let us give the credit to the Congress Party as well as to the India Alliance partners. Let me complete it. Now, the Congress Party and the India Alliance had a narrative. We addressed the unemployment. We addressed the price rise. We provided solutions for that one. People of India has recognized that one. Now, the people of India has voted out against the Modi's guarantee. It is very clear. Because else, Modi's guarantee would have got a 400 plus. Now they don't even have the majority of a single party with 272 plus on their own. They have to go for it, NDA alliance. Now, look at, you know, in the last 10 years of the news channels, how many times you have said NDA than BJP. Now, suddenly all of you are saying NDA. Now, in the last 10 years, then BJP themselves have insulted and they've shown their arrogance to the NDA partners, and suddenly now they need NDA partners. This is you know, this is a failure.
You know, one of the big losses in Uttar Pradesh. Tick, tick, tick.
Shreya.
Okay. But, you know, since we are taking about Uttar Pradesh, just a minute. Since we are talking about Uttar Pradesh, one of the big defeats and the big upsets for the BJP has been in Amethi. I believe Smriti Irani, who's lost the seat to Kishori Lalji, is now speaking to the press. We can quickly go ahead and listen to her.
Aaj is manch par Bharatiya Janata Party ki ek peedhi aisi hai जिन्होंने अमेठी में संघर्ष शुरू किया 1970 के दशक में, एक पीढ़ी ऐसी जो साल 2014 से लेकर 24 तक हारी जीती और आज फिर संघर्ष के मोड़ पर खड़ी है। सर्वप्रथम भाजपा के सभी समर्थकों को, कार्यकर्ताओं को मैं विशेष आभार व्यक्त करती हूं, जिन्होंने पूर्ण परिश्रम और निष्ठा के साथ क्षेत्र की और पार्टी की सेवा की। हर गांव में नाली खड़ंजा से लेकर बाईपास मेडिकल कॉलेज, 30-30 वर्ष पुरानी लोकसभा क्षेत्र की मांगों को पूरा करने का सौभाग्य मुझे प्राप्त हुआ। आज मैं नरेंद्र मोदी, योगी आदित्यनाथ जी का विशेष आभार व्यक्त करती हूं कि
Okay, that is Smriti Irani there in a press conference, essentially accepting defeat. Chandrasekhar Jha, your spokesperson of the Shiv Sena, you've been very patiently waiting for us. We had hoped that we could be in a position to discuss Maharashtra. We'll, of course, do that in the course of programming here on Mirror Now. We love Maharashtra and we love the sort of politics and the sort of results that it has thrown up. But very quickly, when it comes to the national picture, should the NDA alliance look at the numbers as a victory or a defeat? In this case, you know, the way I'm putting it, the victor is actually coming in third.
See, what has happened today, it is a complete mandate which the public has made. And the mandate is completely against Mr. Modi. And BJP was not in picture because all the elections have happened on the picture of Mr. Modi. So deliberately, they are trying to escape now that the whole of NDA has got this much of seat and that much of seat. But this does not absolve them from the liability that public has completely rejected them. And at this moment, in total of the India, what the alliance happened and how this poll has been conducted, over how many times Mr. Modi got down from his position being a PM, how did he misinterpret and misguided the public. Everything is now in picture.
Okay.
The guarantee of Mr. Modi was never ever guaranteed or was done by Mr. Modi. It was just a jumla, and that jumla has been given answer by the public of India. It's a complete dance of democracy. And if you see the dance of democracy, the public is the only, particularly the public has decided upon the
Sutradhar.
Mandate, and Mr. Modi should go. And that mandate is very clear right now. And in every aspect,
you're saying
India
why are you saying Prime Minister Modi should go? You know, I understand that Uddhav Thackeray is a big winner when it comes to Maharashtra, right? But why are you saying that the Prime Minister needs to go? I understand that in the Congress press conference, Mallikarjun Kharge started the press conference saying this mandate is against Prime Minister Modi, but he stopped there. He stopped short of saying that the Prime Minister should resign, etc., etc. So right now with the numbers as they stand, and these are leads that we are looking at, that, you know, I think the result is very clear. The NDA is at 293, 272, I'm just going to keep repeating myself, is the halfway mark, which means the NDA very much in a position to form the next government. and Prime Minister Modi to get a third term. Historic, because the only other Prime Minister who's got a third term in India before him has been Jawaharlal Nehru. Now, we are expecting, ladies and gentlemen, the Prime Minister to speak at 7 or 7.30. 7 o'clock was the time given to us, but that could stretch and probably go to 7.30 as well. So, we'll wait to hear from the Prime Minister and what he has to say. For the moment, what an interesting, incredible day this has been. But it's not ending here. It's not ending here, because tomorrow promises to hold to be even more interesting than today, because we'll get to know whether the India Alliance decides it wants to sit in opposition to, or to make an attempt to actually stitch together a government trying to push the TDP and possibly the JDU as well. All these questions still hanging in the air, ladies and gentlemen. 7.30 when the Prime Minister is expected to speak. I'm slipping into a quick break on the show. Our coverage continues. Do stay with us.